Dr. Katz, you mentioned in a previous talk that 23,000 people in a study had an 80% less lifetime risk of all major chronic diseases such as heart disease, stroke, diabetes, cancer, and dementia. What did these people do to achieve this result? Dr. Willett, tell us about the study out of Harvard that showed the higher the percentage of total calories from saturated fat from meat, processed meat, dairy, and processed dairy, the higher the rate of premature death from all causes. The higher the percentage of fat from unsaturated sources, the lower the rate of premature death. Dr. Campbell, in chapter 13 of the China study, what did you mean by science, the dark side? Dr. Esselstein, why do you say we have built a billion-dollar industry around an illness that does not even exist on half the planet? Is it really possible to be heart attack-proof, or is that just a way to get everyone's attention? Can we really go to, what does that mean? Does that mean we could really completely eliminate the risk? Dr. Goldhammer, what is the ideal fasting schedule for a person who is going to do it from home? Should they fast one day a week for each month, once every 3 months? How long would the fast be if they wanted to do it from home? Dr. Popper and Brenda Davis, our audience is probably predominantly women, and it's probably more of an over 40 audience. What is the reality for premenopause and menopause? In other words, what should women expect their hormones, their emotional state, their physical state, their sex drive to be? It seems like it's an under-discussed topic, and women are led to believe that they're supposed to be like they are in their 30s when it's completely a different situation, and it's not really addressed. So what is the realistic expectation of what they should be expecting, and what can they do to make it the most comfortable experience? Anyone can start and answer your question.
Well, I'll go first. I'm better now than I was in my 30s. In my 30s, I was still eating cheese and I was fat, so this is a whole lot better. I think that the thing that we have done in the United States is we have medicalized women's stages of life. Women can have a menstrual period without some kind of intervention. They have trouble getting pregnant. Pregnancy is treated like a disease. Menopause is a disease that requires treatment. And I always think about how it must have been when we were hunter-gatherers and cave dwellers, and somebody said, well, I can't go looking for food today, I'm PMSing. I mean, seriously, this is not the way we were designed to live. So what happens at menopause is that it all catches up with you. You know, the bad habits, the excessive eating, being overweight, not exercising, not taking care of yourself, the older you get, the more this stuff catches up with you. And so most of the women who come to me to talk about what do I do about menopause, I'm miserable, if you ask them enough questions, they'll tell you that they were miserable when they had their first menstrual period, now at the age of 8, unfortunately. It used to be a lot older than that. And then ever since then, they've been having problems. So the key is, the earlier you start taking care of yourself, the more uneventful this will be. And uneventful meaning it doesn't really change much other than we are all getting older and we can't do much about that, darn it, because I'd love to stick around for a couple hundred more years if I could. But if you have reached the age of menopause, now what you have to do is the accelerated program. In other words, you got to get in the gym and take off that weight, and go to hot yoga, and start sleeping well, and eat an optimal diet, and get yourself hydrated, and you got to stop running around after everything on the planet except for yourself. I mean, I've been thinking about writing a book called Me First, Why You Should Take Care of Yourself Before You Worry About Everything Else on the Planet. And the good news about women who are in this condition is they're willing to do anything, even go to the gym and eat plants. I mean, they're really miserable. And one of the best things that's helped in terms of motivating them is some of the more recent studies that have come out. One large one recently showed that any hormone replacement, estrogen alone, progesterone alone, combination together, any period of time you take it, increases your risk of breast cancer. So women are once again feeling a little terrified of hormone replacement, which they should be, and they're very motivated to approach this from a diet and lifestyle perspective. So that's all good.
Steve, can I ask you, did I have the same question as Pam?
Yes.
Oh, okay, well, I guess we may as well, I'll contribute as well. You know, I completely agree, you know, talking about how you feel even better than you did when you were in your 30s. I can honestly say I don't really feel much different than I did when I was in my 30s. And I'm 61 years old now, and I've been married for, well, it'll be 42 years this year. And yes, certainly after menopause, things can change a little bit. But, you know, I think that the most important thing is that you're making healthy choices in every aspect of your life, balancing your life in terms of your family, what you do socially, but also, of course, all of the healthy choices you make. But the thing that people need to realize is that if you keep doing what you're doing, making healthy choices in your 20s and 30s and 40s and so on, things don't change quite as quickly. And so, I mean, honestly, and not to be braggy or anything, but I think I can still run as fast as I did in my 30s. I can still do the splits and headstands and handstands and, you know, all of those things, the push-ups and all of those things. It doesn't, I find that it's not changing quickly, and I'm really hoping that it'll continue. I absolutely love this story that John Robbins tells in one of his books about this 96-year-old, I think he was 96-year-old, a martial artist who was pitted against a 39-year-old world champion boxer for the Millennium Celebrations. And these two men were put in the ring, and the boxer was just, he just kept trying to hit this old man, and the old man kept dodging him. And after about 20 minutes, the young boxer was getting really tired, lost his concentration, the old man flattened him. And of course, the reporters came running, and they said to the young guy, well, what happened? How can you explain this? He said, I don't know, but the old man just beat me. They went to the old man, and they said, well, you know, how can you explain beating a 39-year-old boxer, a world champion boxer? And the old man said, I don't understand why anyone's surprised. I have far more experience than he does. And I think we can all take a lesson from that. But I you know, as in terms of diet and going through menopause and so forth, it's the same song and dance all over again. A lot of greens and beans. And I actually didn't really notice menopause, to be honest. I didn't feel much of anything. I felt fine. I didn't have a lot of hot flashes or anything like that. I do eat soy on a pretty regular basis. I eat a lot of greens. I eat very healthfully. I eat plenty of essential fatty acids and so forth. And so I think that's just a lot of the experience of a lot of people who eat either exclusively or largely plant-based diet, that they sail through fairly easily.